out of long range again. It is a war of attrition, boy.
Welcome to MSG Fight Night. I'm John Dotti, and joining me is Mark Breland. And tonight we're going to be taking a look back to watch Ray Boom Boom Mancini taking on Livingston Bramble. Mark, this fight happened up in Buffalo, New York. Back then, fighting was really popular, and especially for the smaller weights, and Ray Boom Boom Mancini was one of those reasons.
Oh yeah, the smaller weights were big back then. You had Ray Leonard, you had Alexis Aguirre, Roberto Duran. All of the small guys were big bangers.
Yeah, and in attendance that night, you also had Hector Camacho and Aaron Pryor, and they were all watering at the mouth, wanting to fight Ray Boom Boom Mancini. But first, he had to get through Livingston Bramble. Tell us about Livingston.
I mean, Livingston was a very, very tough guy. You know, his style was, he had a very awkward style, just coming in, throwing a lot, but he was very smart. But the weird thing about him, he had very long arms, and he would bring his hands here. His hands blocked everything, his arms blocked it all. But he had a very, very awkward style, but he was a very, very tough fighter.
Yeah. Let's take a look back at the action up in Buffalo, New York, where we're going to see Ray Boom Boom Mancini taking on Livingston Bramble.
Wearing gold, red, and green, he weighs 134.5 pounds. His record, 20 wins, 13 by knockout, only one loss and one draw. Originally from the Virgin Islands, now fighting out of Passaic, New Jersey, the number one challenger in the world, ladies and gentlemen, Livingston Pitbull Bramble. And now in the red corner, wearing green with red trim, weighing 135 pounds even. He has 29 victories in 30 fights with 23 knockouts and has defended his title four times, all by knockout victories. From Youngstown, Ohio, introducing the WBA lightweight champion of the world, Ray Boom Boom Mancini.
Mancini, obviously a very charismatic man. Let's get the instructions from referee Marty Denken.
I gave you instructions in the dressing room. I'll give you the best I have, but you got to give me the best you have. I will enforce the rules. I'll hold you responsible, Lou. Griffin, I'll hold you responsible. Okay? Good luck. Let's do the best you can, gentlemen. I appreciate it. Go ahead,
baby. They go back to their corners. Mancini just above us. Bramble across the way, getting last-minute instructions from Lou Duva. The referee, Marty Denken, in the middle of the ring. All right, we are ready. Round number one. Mancini swinging widely, Bramble keeping his punches inside, Ray using the bob and weave style that was first popularized by the great Jack Dempsey.
Mancini already very close to Bramble. They are going to fight this on the inside. Bramble, some people wondered, would he box against Mancini, try and use the reach and jab and hit him with a straight right hand? Not doing that. He is right in the trenches with Mancini, and already a low blow by Ray Mancini.
And he gets a warning from the referee, Marty Denken. Mancini in the green trunks, Bramble in the gold trunks. 2 minutes remain in round number one, Al.
Both are good body punchers. That is certainly Mancini's stock in trade, and he will try and work the body. There he does with a left hook to Bramble.
You will have to watch closely with Bramble. He likes to counter with right hands. Mancini, who's a converted southpaw, has a tough right hand, and he's using it right now to advantage.
Some people believe Bramble has not faced the kind of pressure that Mancini will put on him. Certainly no one has been able to do that against him as well as Mancini will, and they wonder if Bramble can sustain under that pressure.
Wild right by Bramble, who so far has not indicated that he is in any way tied up by the moment.
Well, Mancini has landed good jabs, and Mancini has also shown good head movement getting away from a lot of the jabs and straight rights from Bramble. That's good news for him in this first round. Well, this is where Mancini wants this fight, right here. He is landing good shots. And doing a very good job avoiding Bramble, but a good left hook.
Yes, you're absolutely right. A good hook, left hook by Bramble, and again, big surprise. Bumpus in the first fight decided to slug it out, and apparently Bramble feels the same way. That is the Duva plan of the night. Take it to them.
Bramble's certainly less of a boxer than Bumpus, so it's not that surprising, but we did expect a little bit more lateral movement from Livingstone Bramble.
The referee now cautioning both fighters for using their hands.
There is a cut
over Mancini's eye, and he's being led back to the corner.
It's a terrible cut.
This may be a great deal of pressure. The doctor, Armin Cincotta, from Syracuse, is being asked to look at it, but he is not the last voice. The last voice is the referee, Marty Denken. Now, if he deems it, he's decided to let it go. Did he think it was a butt or did he? Yes, he thought it was a butt, which is an important thing. All right. 26, 25 seconds remain. And the most important man in Buffalo, New York right now is Paul Percyfield, who's got to stop the bleeding on the cut of Mancini. Mancini working hard because he knows he's in a difficult position. We will stay right here and go to the corner as Bramble has now decided to work from the left side. And Mancini putting pressure on. And the bell ends round number one. Let's go back to the corner and see what Paul Percyfield does. And Al, you take a close look and see exactly where the cut is.
It looks like it's on just off to the right side of the right eye. If it's off to the right side, of course, that will make it less of a problem. If it's right on the eyelid, then Ray Mancini has a tremendous... Oh, it's right on the eyelid. That is in about the worst place you can possibly have a cut. Now, the question is whether they ruled it an accidental
butt or a deliberate butt.
If it's an accidental butt, Bill, it cannot end the fight. It would be a technical draw before the third round.
Let me get Marty.
Let's take a look. There's where they clashed heads, I guess. It was initiated by both fighters, it appeared.
But Marty. Was it a butt? Was it a butt? Was it a butt? Yes, he says it was a butt. Now the question is, was it accidental? Mancini coming out. This is almost like the Sugar Ray Robinson fight with Randy Turpin, where Robinson cut desperately, had to come back and knock his man out.
Well, this certainly alters drastically the strategy of this fight. Mancini went all out toward the end of that last round to try and get Bramble out of there. And again, we wonder about the interpretation. If it's a butt, if he called it a deliberate butt, then a point would have been taken away. I don't think it was a deliberate butt. It was an accidental clash of heads. If it goes past the third round and this fight is stopped because of that clash of heads, they should go to the scorecards.
They will, yes, to see who's ahead. Good left hook by Bramble.
Well, that is the one thing that the Mancini people were most concerned with. And Bramble uses his head a little bit. That time, it didn't look like an accident.
Good right uppercut. He's beating Mancini to the punch. Mancini's a little wide.
Mancini with an excellent left hook, and he's getting the jab in. This fight is a war.
Yes, it is.
Mancini desperate because of the cut, and so he has gone to war with Bramble. And Bramble willing to stay in there and trade punches. So far, he's been able to do it.
Mancini before tried to get in close. Now he's fighting him at long range and trying to use the right to the body to set up the left hook to the head. But he's got to stay away as Bramble opens up on him, and Mancini hit him again, and there's more blood from the eye of Ray Mancini.
Despite the cut, Mancini's doing an excellent job on the inside. Bramble landing his shots, but Mancini just a little quicker in most instances. Good uppercuts by Mancini. He's using that punch effectively. And the jab of Mancini, a key weapon here. Most people didn't expect him to be able to use it against the taller Bramble, but Bramble's leaning in, making that punch effective.
Ray Mancini in the green trunks. Livingstone Bramble in the gold trunks. And Mancini is boxing him now, giving an indication of the kind of fighter he can be under these extreme circumstances where his eye was busted up in the first round.
Good right by Bramble, but boy, Mancini can take a punch, and he showed it again there.
Al, I'm looking at his eye. I said before he was bleeding. I don't think he has. I think Persifield stopped the bleeding. Mancini staying in and using the left hook. Took a tremendous lift to the eye. Well, 11, 10 seconds remaining in round number two. This is a key round in deciding the verdict in the fight. Mention it again, Al.
Well, because if the fight should be stopped now because of the cut, an accidental butt, they would not be able to go to the scorecards. But after this round, they would be able to go to the scorecards to determine a winner if that cut would cause this fight to be stopped.
Because of the fact that it was a butt.
Right, although it was an accidental clash of heads.
Mancini going to work on him in close with a right to the body and the left hook. Bramble fighting him as a righty now.
One thing Bramble has done better in this fight than in previous fights is stay on balance. He's throwing his punches with good leverage, but Mancini, oh, that left hook may have rocked Bramble.
Yes, it did. He might have been a little off balance, but Mancini is showing his tremendous tenacity, bulldog quality. But I tell you, Paul Persifield did a good job in the eye. No bleeding.
Bramble has an excellent left hook. That's been his best weapon so far in this fight. Mancini's walked into a few. A lot of pressure from Ray, and this is what people wonder. Can Bramble, who has not fought the competition of Mancini, can he sustain under this pressure? Ray is certainly putting pressure on him.
Using the elbows, he may be the strongest physical lightweight that we've had in years. He's almost a throwback to Bob Montgomery, and he just stands on top of Bramble. Taking chances, though, because that right side is exposed and the right eye has been cut.
You know, a lot of those punches picked off by Bramble, but a lot are getting through also.
I don't get the impression that there's any hysteria in the Mancini corner because of the cut.
No, Murphy Griffith is telling him to do the right thing. He's saying, keep using your jab. That punch is setting things up, and it's landing against Bramble. There it is again. I think that's a plus. Mancini didn't expect that punch to be there.
If you've just joined us, we've already had an upset tonight. Johnny Bumpus was knocked out by Gene Hatcher. Mancini taking shots to the head to return shots. And this has been a war, in your words, Al.
Bramble switches to the southpaw style, and that may be to defend against that left hook. He lands a good straight left hand, Bramble does, from this posture.
And now Livingston Bramble becomes a southpaw.
You know, Mancini had trouble with Orlando Romero, the last southpaw he faced last year. So that maybe Bramble looked at those tapes and decided this could work, and there's a good right hook. Bramble's been effective now from the southpaw stance. An interesting move by him, and it's worked.
We have about 23, 22, 21, 20 seconds remaining. We've had trouble with the timekeeper all night long, and that's why we say about. But the third round's about to end, and from here in, Mancini took a hard left uppercut. Got his right hand and took a right hand. I mentioned Paul Persifield before, the cut man in Mancini's corner. He's a very wealthy man who does this simply because he loves boxing. He may become the most important man in Ray Mancini's career.
And he has done a remarkable job on that cut, and so far kept him in the fight. Bramble has come out in this round as a right-hander, and I wonder why. Bill, he was so effective as a southpaw in that last round.
Well, again, here, as we talked about in the Bumpus fight, Bramble obviously doesn't think this man can hurt him. So he goes either way, but he must know better.
Here's what being a lefty does to help Bramble. First of all, he can land his right hook better because it's closer to Mancini's head. Secondly, he makes Mancini's left jab less effective. And that was the punch that was really doing the damage and setting things up against Bramble.
As he's doing right now, but he took a right cross from Bramble. The sneak right by Bramble. He's got that quick right hand. It's very dangerous. Mancini going to the body was slowed up a little by a hard punch to the head.
Bramble is covering up much better here in this round as he was toward the end of the third round.
Minute 45 remaining in round number four. There is no bleeding from Mancini's eye, and to the best that I can see from here, The eye does not appear swollen. He can see out of it. Good right hand by Mancini. They're yelling at Mancini from his corner. Underneath. You probably hear it the way we do.
They want him to work Bramble's body. Bramble's doing a pretty good job of covering up to the body, but Ray is getting in with that punch. The jab again of Mancini. I'll tell you, that's a very good weapon. He landed it against Chacon, as I said, a much shorter fighter, but doing well against Bramble. Excellent right by Mancini.
Good right, counter. As I mentioned to you before, Mancini uses his left hand. He's a lefty in everything but boxing and batting in baseball. He's a converted southpaw, and that right hand is very much underrated. He's in a war.
He is banging the body of Bramble with that right hand. You wonder what toll that will take later in the fight, if we get to later in the fight.
Bramble fighting back.
There is never an easy fight for Ray Mancini, and this one, again, a very tough one.
Sports Night of Champions will continue after this message from your local station.
You know, Livingstone Bramble's the number one rated contender by the WBA. Some people thought that was suspect. He's showing us tonight it's not suspect. He's an excellent fighter, and he is performing as well in this fight as he ever has as a pro.
So that the pressure has not gotten to him, but we're looking at a different Mancini. Mancini is boxing him now, using a stiff left jab, and then using the right hand over it. Apparently, they've told him to box it.
Well, these are the skills that Ray has worked on continually, and in the last several years has improved on. He's still standing pretty erect and taking a few too many Bramble lefts and rights, but he's doing a good job with that jab.
That's Ray's best punch, in my opinion, that left hook to the body. That does more damage than almost any other punch. It sets up the other fighter for the rain of blows to the head. Jab, jab, and then the hook and the right. And Bramble standing there as if he's loading up.
Well, he is, but Ray Mancini's doing the work. Oh, good right by Bramble.
Warning to Bramble about using his elbows. Mancini coming on, warding him off with the elbows and coming at him.
Good body work again by Mancini. He's abandoned that a little bit.
Good left hook by Bramble. Tough fight.
Indeed, and both these fighters doing what they do and doing it extremely well. They're both fighting excellently.
Mancini does not go up on his toes, but he's using the left jab to work off of, taking a left jab from Bramble, though.
You know, for the first time, Bramble is starting to use his jab. Really a surprise. He's got the reach and height advantage, and he's got a fairly good left jab, but the punch has been in mothballs until this round. Great body work by Mancini.
It's been a different kind of fight than you would expect from Mancini. You would expect him to come in as he is right now underneath, but they keep yelling at him from the corner. Circle him in jab. Good right hand by Mancini.
Well, it's been a fight on the inside, but Mancini found out that from just a slightly longer distance away, he could land the jab in these combinations, so he's done it. He didn't have to be fighting right off the chest of Bramble, though he is right now.
And doing it effectively. He's got Bramble cornered, and he's using the body blows to set him up.
We're here at Mendez Boxing Gym, and Mark, I gotta give a big shout out to Ray Boom Boom's cutman, Paul Percyfield. He did an amazing job on his eye. It never became a factor in the fight, but what did become a factor was when Livingston started turning southpaw. He already did it once in this fight, and we're gonna see it a lot more. Why is that giving Ray so much trouble?
I mean, in this position right here, every time Ray gets ready to throw his hook, Bramble just throws it straight right in, straight on, every time. And if he tries to throw a jab, if he throws the jab, he comes over the jab with another hook. So he's just throwing him off his game the whole time.
It really did throw him off his game. Let's go back and join the action up in Buffalo, New York.
getting ready for round number seven. Al, how do you have it scored through the first six?
I've got Ray Mancini leading 59-56, and believe me, those rounds have been very close, so the judges may be seeing it differently. You know, Bill, back in round three, Bramble turned to the southpaw stance, was very effective over about a minute and a half period. He has never gone back to that, and I'm really wondering why.
Mancini now using his power, but Bramble got him with a right hand.
That was a solid right as Bramble can throw, and Ray did not back off.
There's almost a tendency to say about Mancini that he's a little Rocky Marciano, except I never saw Marciano stand there and use the left jab as a weapon the way Mancini is.
Well, there's an indication of some of the skills Mancini has honed and improved on. But unfortunately, in this fight, he's showing they still need some work on defense. But then again, he's got a very quick and good puncher in front of him in Livingstone Bramble.
Good right hand by Bramble. The corner yelling at Ray because when he throws the right and he throws the left, he leads to it with his head. And he took a right hand there.
You know, oh, good right by Mancini. One of the wild cards here is all the body work Mancini has done. That could have a big impact on Bramble. Bramble has not done much body work at all against Mancini.
Now, he's been the headhunter in this fight. We mentioned at the beginning of the fight that there is no love lost between the two. That's putting it mildly. Mancini hates him.
And there is Bramble turning from southpaw stance, and immediately he lands a right hook. And that one may have stunned Ray. Oh, it took him about four rounds to get back to this style, but he's there.
Yes, he is. And it's confusing to Mancini, but when Mancini is in trouble, he just fights on and goes to the body. It's been an excellent fight. With a minute remaining in this, the seventh round of a scheduled 15-rounder. He hit him with a good right hand. Bramble takes a heck of a punch.
Sure does. Bramble again with the right hook. That's the punch that from the southpaw stance has worked fairly well for him. They want Mancini to move to his left to get outside that right foot of Bramble.
Oh, he hurt Mancini. He has Mancini in trouble. He has him in trouble.
It was the right hook again, and Bramble does not follow up on it. Why? They are waving to Bramble from his corner to move in, and he simply isn't doing it.
The same advice that you had for Bumpus, opponent Hatcher, you have for Mancini. He is moving right into that right hook. It's been a good round for Livingston Bramble. We're coming to the end of the seventh round. That Sports Night of Champions will continue after this message from your local station. You're looking at Livingston Bramble, who has given Ray Mancini everything he wants. He's got a different type of hairdo, and the Samson hairdo that Mancini wears is now mired down in wetness. His corner, obviously, telling him to stay away, and Bernstein, I can't believe it. He's gone back to fighting him righty again after having all the trouble.
Isn't that astonishing? Now, he is still landing punches, but I'll tell you, as a lefty, he was so much more effective. But he is getting, and there he is. He's now back to southpaw. They want Ray to move. He's not moving. He's standing and exchanging with Bramble, and he's paying for it. Ray is in trouble. He is getting
hit
with a lot of shots. They wondered, could Bramble sustain against the pressure of Mancini? Thus far, he's done it. He has taken a lot from Ray Mancini over the first seven rounds, and he's still there, and he is hurting Ray.
I'm wondering right now again whether it's a matter of macho with Ray because he dislikes this man so much that he won't move.
I think that is a valid argument. That's conceivable. And maybe Ray is just too tired to box and move. He has exerted a lot of energy. He has thrown many punches over these first seven and a half rounds. He cannot deal with the southpaw stance of Bramble. It's what gave him trouble against Orlando Romero last September in Madison Square Garden. He was fortunate to win a close fight on a knockout in that instance.
Mancini now loading up, trying to do it with a punch and taking punishment in return.
He is very tired. I think Ray is
fatigued. He's got to get a second breath. They're yelling at him from the corner. Move. He may be on his way down. He's in trouble as he was against Darquayle. Took a hard right.
The right hook as a southpaw for Bramble is landing almost every time he throws it. Ray cannot defend against that punch. His left is low.
They're screaming at Ray. Merv Griffin, Dave Wolf in his corner. Move, move, move. Mancini having difficulty, and Bramble knows it.
Ray Mancini pulled one out of his bag of tricks against Romero. Big left hook. Can he do it tonight against Bramble? He's awfully tired. He's getting hit a lot.
Yes, he is. Bramble shows no emotion. No.
People wondered about Bramble's toughness. Could he take the attack from Mancini? He has. He's been hit a lot this fight. Keeps coming forward, does Livingstone Bramble.
His catch sports.
He may have hurt Bramble with a left hand.
Yes, he might have. He's moving in on him now. Oh, they are really hammering. Which one puts first? They've gone a long range again. It is a war of attrition.
Boy, people will remember round eight of this fight for a long time.
Here in the seventh round might have been the turning point, if there is one in the fight, Al.
Bramble hurt him with a right hook, wobbled Mancini, and that right hook as a southpaw was the punch that put Ray in trouble in the seventh, and of course in the eighth even more trouble, but Ray, as we look at him, did come back toward the end of that round and wobbled Livingstone Bramble. Boy, could you ask for more from a boxing match.
Cat Sports Night of Champions has turned into Cat Sports Night of Upsets.
Well, if indeed Livingstone Bramble can sustain this, I still have Mancini ahead 77-76, though I have given Bramble the last two rounds.
He's beating Mancini to the punch with a right hand. And they're telling him, use the left jab, use the left jab. But Ray wants to get in there and bang with him. And when he does, he's having difficulty.
Now, Bramble came out as a righty again. Let's see if he does what he did the last round. Change to southpaw after about 30 or 40 seconds. If he doesn't, I'll be very surprised. There's the jab by Mancini. That punch has not been effective the last two or three rounds because Bramble has fought mostly as a southpaw.
Is this about the time he catches the second breath out?
Normally, in his fights, it is exactly the time. Just when you think he can't possibly do it. So that would fit in with tonight's script.
Oh, a left hook. Bramble is not supposed to be that great a puncher, but with less than 2 minutes left, and this is the ninth round, he has shown good punching power.
He's got good power. He's not a devastating puncher, but he does have good power.
I believe Bramble is beginning to enjoy this fight.
Well, he mugged at Mancini toward the end of the last round. Dankin's trying to get in and warn Bramble about holding. And he just went in and threw a shot at Mancini, but a show of sportsmanship by both fighters touching gloves. That is surprising.
Psychologically, what Bramble did before the fight, getting Mancini as angry as he did, may be effective for him because Mancini will not listen to his corner. Mancini said before the fight, he said Bramble doesn't listen to his corner, and yet now they're yelling to him, use your jab, and they're screaming, and he won't. He wants to stay in there and
smoke. I think part of that is the fatigue. He can't move. He's using the jab, but he can't move. Early in the fight, he was disciplined, so perhaps now some of that anger coming out, but I think it's more a question of fatigue on Mancini's part. He just can't move as well as he'd like to.
Coming up to 40 seconds left in this, the ninth round, scheduled for 15, and it has literally been a war. Oh, now he's back to fighting him righty, and that's where he does most of his damage.
As a left-hander, Bramble is doing the job on Mancini, as he has throughout most of the fight when he's fought from that posture.
And now it's Bramble who is the aggressor pursuing Mancini against the ropes.
And there's a cut now on the left eye of Mancini.
Cut over the right, cover over the left eye, and we're coming up to the 10th round. Mancini bounces out of his corner as if he's alive and well. How do you have it scored now, Al?
Dead even, 86-86, because I have given Bramble the last three rounds rather decisively, and so from my standpoint, this fight is dead even, but it's not really even because Bramble is the fresher of the two, and he is hurting Ray Mancini. So unless Ray does something dramatic, he's going to be in trouble in this fight, or unless the body work he did early to Bramble has some impact as this fight wears on.
And Bramble now has gone back to fighting him as a lefty, and what Ray is trying to answer with is that right, and that may be the wrong punch.
When we were down in Houston, I saw Bramble fight as a lefty a lot in the gym. I really didn't think he would use it this much in the fight, but it's turned out to be the wild card in this fight. It's the tactical move that I don't think Mancini expected, and it has produced some excellent results for Livingstone Bramble.
The punches he just threw, the left hooks to the body, are the best punches against a lefty fighter, and he's got to stick with that, and as you said, keep that right foot out. But there he's getting hit again.
Well, and the funny thing is the left hook to the body and the head is one of his best punches. One of the frustrating points is he's hit Bramble with some tremendous shots, but Livingstone Bramble just hasn't been effective. Once or twice he was wobbled. Good right by Mancini, but again, he can't hurt Bramble.
The other part about it that surprises me is how strong Bramble is physically. We talked that Mancini might be the strongest lightweight, and yet Bramble is pushing him around.
Mancini just landed two terrific shots, and it didn't even slow Bramble down. So Livingstone Bramble, a tremendous chin. No one's hurt him thus far in his career, and Mancini hasn't done it either. His only loss to Bramble, an eight-round loss to Anthony Fletcher. In that fight, he was not hurt.
The Anthony Fletcher that Al referred to is Frank the Animal Fletcher's buddy, brother.
You know, Ray is having a fairly good round here. He's taken some big shots, but he has landed some as well. But you can tell he just looks much more tired.
Yes, he does now. He surely does.
He's standing straight up because he's tired, and that's why he's taking a lot of those shots. You know, he can land the straight right against Bramble. He's done it in this round a lot when Bramble's in the southpaw stance, but Bill, it has no impact, and Bramble just keeps coming.
I was going to say that I thought that Mancini had gotten his second win, but here at the end of round number 10, it does not look like it.
He's landing, but it's having no impact. He might steal this round with the number of punches, but Bramble landing the more effective blow.
Oh, he got tagged with that right hook again.
He simply can't hurt Livingstone Bramble, and right now that's the story of this fight.
Sports Night of Champions will continue after this message from your local station. I believe it was Jose Torres who first said that every fight is a matter of will. And so far, Bramble, in the last number of rounds, has imposed his will on Mancini. Now, Ray Mancini has been in this kind of situation before. Question is, can he do anything about it, Al?
Well, the difference between this fight and others is that he is landing good shots to the head of Livingstone Bramble, and early he landed excellent punches to the body. It just isn't having any impact on Bramble, unless Bramble is doing a great job of disguising it, and Bramble is landing the hardest shots. Now, the last round, a tough one to score in some respects because Mancini landed a lot of punches. I gave it to Bramble because I thought he landed a lot of punches and they were effective, but Mancini probably landed more. But again, the judges are becoming key figures in this fight. How much of an early lead did they give to Mancini?
Those judges are Mike Liena, Stan Berg, and Lou Moretta. The rounds begin almost the same. Mancini comes out, charges in, does all his work in a minute and a half, and then has to defend his life the last minute and a half.
It's a very good point, Bill. And at the beginning of every round, Bramble comes out right-handed. Mancini does fairly well, and then about a minute into the round, Bramble changes to the southpaw stance, and that's when he does his best work. See if it happens again. So far, and there it is, exactly, well, a minute and a half into the round, he changed.
He loaded up and hit him with a right hand and did nothing and got hurt with a left hook.
And as soon as he changed to the southpaw stance, he landed a straight left and a right hook. And there's the right hook again by Livingstone Bramble.
You wonder why that would be such a tough punch for Mancini, except that he drops his left hand.
Andy, because he is staying within range of that hook, he should be moving to his left and getting the left hook to the body and the head to keep Bramble busy. He's moving into that left hook, right hook.
It is Ray who grabs and holds at this juncture. Less than a minute remaining in round number 11. Scheduled for 15 rounds for the WBA Lightweight Championship of the World. Ray Mancini's face is so well known in America, you hardly have to say who he is. And he is fighting Livingston Bramble and having a terrible struggle. Bramble going into that southpaw stance, now goes back to the orthodox stance.
You can almost see that Ray's eyes light up when he goes back to righty. He feels he has a better shot that way. Ray's jab lands better when Bramble is a righty. He's landing it now. Ray is not busy on the inside, an indication he is tired.
Here's Bramble doing exactly what we talked about, making the strong close. How much trouble he would give Mancini. Ray comes out as he does in every round, charging at the start.
Camacho, of course, looking at what could potentially be a tremendous money fight against Mancini. Aaron Pryor is here also, and I tell you, somebody saw Camacho in the hotel, and they said, you like Mancini, huh? He said, I would like Mancini against anybody in the world, even a heavyweight, because I want that payday. But right now, it could be slipping away, although this is a very close fight.
Notice that Bramble has gone to the lefty stance a little earlier. This time, not with a minute and a half remaining in the round, but with 220 and more. And he hurts him every time with that right hook.
Can you imagine why he would fight any of this fight as a righty? It's hard for me even to fathom after he's found such success as a lefty.
Has Ray found his second win?
Well, he's punching a lot, but they're not having that much impact. And, of course, he is tired. But you know what you have to say about Bramble? We are into the latter stages of this fight, into the 12th round. And despite all the body work and the punches he's been hit with, he looks pretty fresh. He has never been this far, Livingstone Bramble. This is the farthest he has ever been in a fight.
Second fighter from the Virgin Islands to fight for World's Championship. The first, the great Emil Griffith, who is both the welterweight and middleweight champion of the world. Bramble trying to get on top of Ray. Ray trying to stay underneath him and close with him. And they're yelling, move, move, move. And it's such an unusual style for Ray, who likes working in under the bob and weave and going to the body. And here he's had to be the boxer against the man he supposedly could take out. Bramble back to the lefty again now.
What's ironic is that Ray has shown us a good jab in this fight, and he's shown us some good combination work. It just hasn't fazed Bramble. You know, these rounds are pretty close. Even though Bramble's landing the big shots, Ray is landing a lot of punches.
Yes, he is, and he hurt Bramble a little bit with a left hook. The thing about Bramble is, you can't tell. The face is totally impassive.
He has been stoic throughout this fight, Bramble has, and as you say, you just can't tell what is moving him, if anything. They want Ray outside. They don't want him fighting off Bramble's chest. That's where we thought he wanted to be.
Al, I tell you, I'm not sure I agree with him. I think he's better staying inside.
Staying away from good. That's possible.
I think he's better leaning his head on Bramble's chest and fighting from there. At long range, he's an easy prey for the right hook.
The jab, look at 3-4 straight jabs. No impact on Bramble.
The crowd roaring, but Mancini missed 3 of those punches. It is a struggle. We're coming to the end of the 12th round. Round number 13 of the scheduled 15 rounder. Referee Marty Denken wiping some of the Vaseline off the face of Bramble, as you can see. How do you have it scored, Al?
I have this fight dead even, 105 to 105. That may seem strange because of the rally that Bramble has put on, but remember, Mancini was very effective over the first 6 or 7 rounds. And again, that is quite unofficial.
Mancini now leaning back, and when he does, it makes him an easy prey for an overhand shot, which is what Bramble does. But Bramble in this round deciding to fight him as a righty.
Mancini is not a one-punch knockout artist, but so many times in his career, the accumulation of punches has sent people down. He's hit Bramble with many good shots in this fight, and he has not been able to hurt Livingstone.
Stopped him with a left jab a little bit, then no. We've seen Mancini go to the 14th round and muster enough strength to score knockouts. This time, particularly coming off the easy fight against Bobby Chacon, this has just been a war.
Good right hand by Mancini. That was the first right hand he's thrown with conviction in about four rounds. Could be maybe he is getting some reserve here. Now he's doing a good job of slipping punches. That last right got in, however.
Hit him on the top of the head. He said before the fight tonight to you, I may not have the greatest skills in the world, but I have the heart. And that heart is being tested right now.
That's for sure. There's blood from the left eye and the right eye of Ray Mancini. The right eye is swollen. The left eye is cut. And he fights on.
Bramble picking his shots now. And Mancini holding on a little bit. Round number 13 of this one scheduled for 15 for the WBA Lightweight Championship. And Bramble has suddenly started to vary his attack, working underneath, working overhand, and the corner keeps yelling at Ray, move back, move back. Less than a minute remaining in the 13th round.
I don't think there's any way to give Livingstone Bramble too much credit for both his conditioning and his tenacity tonight. Many people doubted that he could go this long in a war with Mancini. He's never had to do anything like this ever in his career before, and he has done so and done it well.
It's amazing. You look at the face of Mancini, he looks like he's gone through a meat grinder. There is not a mark on Bramble's face.
And he's been hit often, Livingstone Bramble has.
Hit him with the right hand, didn't do anything with it. It's got to be discouraging to Mancini. 13th round, coming to an end, and Mancini's legs go rubbery. That Sports Night of Champions will continue after this message from your local station. A very important moment in the 14th round. Ray was wobbled at the end of the 13th and took a circle route back to his corner. They know it. Both of them, Mancini and Bramble, two rounds left with a world's championship, WBA lightweight championship on the line.
Like most boxing experts, if you will, I would have never suspected Livingstone Bramble could go this long at this pace and be fresh, but he is. To give him credit for it.
He's got Mancini in trouble. Has him in desperate trouble. Mancini on his bicycle looks ready to be taken.
He
looks the way he did against Arguello. He may go down right now. Does he have the reserve? I am not sure. He is helpless, and the fight has been stopped, and Livingstone Bramble has won. Unbelievably, Livingstone Bramble, a 4-1 underdog, has taken the title away from Ray Mancini. You can see David Wolf saying okay to the referee. There are people who just would not believe that Livingstone Bramble can do it. But now Mancini is being looked at by the doctor to see if the eye is okay and to see if the pupils are enlarged to show any head injury. Do we get the decision first? It's in the 14th round. The fight was stopped. Mancini did not take the count. But he looked exactly as he had against Alexis Arguello, out on his feet, ready to go, and the fight was stopped. A shocker. Mike, are you ready up there? Here is Mike Buffer with the decision of the fight.
Referee Marty Denken stops the contest in the 14th round at 53 seconds. The winner by technical knockout and new WBA lightweight champion.
A stunned pro Mancini crowd at the War Memorial Auditorium in Buffalo, New York, has seen Ray Mancini dethroned by Livingstone Bramble on this Cats Sports Night of Champions that, as I've said before, is the Cats Sports Night of Upsets.
We're back at Mendez Boxing, and we just seen Livingston Bramble win the title, and the first guy from the Virgin Islands to win a title since Emil Griffith, and turn southpaw. That really was the key in the fight, wasn't it, Mark?
Oh, yeah, very much so, because it just kept throwing him off and throwing him off. Now, another key in the fight is his defense. He's got very long arms, and when he brings his arms down, his arms are all the way down by his waist, pretty much. When Boom Boom tried to bring him to the body, he's blocking everything right there. Then he's coming here. Boom, he comes on the inside. Boom, he's catching with all different kinds of shots. He's very crafty on the inside.
And they had a rematch, what, a year later? And unfortunately for Boom Boom, it was a wee bit more of the same.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Ray's a great fighter, don't get me wrong, but Bramble was much tougher than him and just was ready for the fight.
He certainly was. Thanks for joining us on MSG Fight Night, where we just seen Livingston Bramble take the title of Ray Boom Boom Mancini.